Now, preparations for the swearing-in of President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni on May the 12th is in high gear. The event will take place at the Kololo Independence Grounds here in Kampala. The Joint Security Task Force that has the mandate to ensure safety and security pre, during and after the event says everything is being done to ensure that everything is safe. This was unveiled during the joint security briefing that was held at the police headquarters in Naguru here in Kampala. Our reporter was there and filed this report.
Police spokesperson Fred Enanga says they are confident of holding a successful event since it was planned for in the security master plan for policing the 2021 general elections.
Basically, I want to inform the public that we are confident that the event will proceed in a very secure manner because it is an activity that we had planned for in the security master plan for policing the 2021 general elections.
The swearing-in ceremony marks the climax of the presidential election. The Electoral Commission Chairperson Justice Simon Byabakama announced President Yoweri Museveni as the winner of the presidential elections with 58% beating his other 10 contestants. He confirmed that there are no specific threats directed towards the swearing-in ceremony, although they anticipate disruptive activities such as use of petrol bombs, acts of sabotage, blocking roads, burning tires and other disruptive activities. However, he said the joint intelligence components have picked this piece of information and continue to gather information surrounding the would-be perpetrators.
Today we want to inform the public that there are no specific threats directed towards the swearing-in ceremony, although we do anticipate as security agencies disruptive activities basically by disgruntled politicians and supporters whom we anticipate will want to disrupt the process through the use of petrol bombs. We've seen previously attempts.
In addition, the police publicists say the Joint Operation Command centers across the country were fully alert with the relevant intelligence, operative and investigative components operating 24/7. They are closely monitoring a wide range of potential threats, especially acts of domestic extremism, external influence, radical behavior, and closely monitoring all border points and closely monitoring all our border areas and crossing points, especially in West Nile region. The police statement comes at a time when the Army's Air Force is also doing rehearsals ahead of the swearing-in ceremony by flying around jet fighters. The jets, which have been flying in the skies of Kampala since last week, have caused excitement among Ugandans and have become a subject of discussion on social media. Meanwhile, Uganda police force is hunting for people suspected to have killed Samuel Musitwa, the brother of Robert Kagolo, who was also gunned down on Thursday last week. Kampala Metropolitan Police spokesperson Luke Owoyesigire revealed that the late Musitwa's body was recovered several days after he went missing. During the time he was missing, the late Musitwa made frantic calls to his family, revealing that he was locked in a car. Musitwa was a brother to journalist Robert Kagolo, who was also gunned down on Thursday last week.
You all know Samuel Musitwa was born in a vehicle last week. And one of the suspects that was arrested was the wife, Ayeko Lolo. This is after the brother, the late Kagolo, came to police and informed police how they were receiving messages from their brother that he was going to be killed.
By my family, my